I think research at the Johns Hopkins Myositis Center poises us in a very unique position. We're fortunate to have a world-class team of researchers and clinicians, and we bring the expertise that we learn from our patients right to the bench, and from the lab bench back to the patients.
We know that autoimmune diseases occur in genetically susceptible people who are exposed to specific environmental exposures and triggers. And one of the things that we've been very interested in at the Myositis Center is defining which populations are susceptible to developing autoimmune disease, and then also figuring out what are the environmental triggers that cause patients to actually go ahead and develop those diseases. We have patients who are in families where one person has myositis, another person has scleroderma, another person has multiple sclerosis. Why is that? What's special about that family that makes them vulnerable to autoimmune diseases in general? We also have patients who are twins, where you have two genetically identical individuals. One person has the autoimmune disease, another person does not. So what is it in the environment that triggers autoimmunity in one individual, leaving the other one who's genetically identical without that disease? These are the kinds of questions that we're trying to answer, because if we can figure out what causes autoimmunity to occur, that puts us in a much better position to prevent it and treat it if it does occur.
I think that Hopkins is a very special place where unique disciplines can learn from one another. This type of interaction is imperative for patient care. It brings back from the lab bench directly to the clinic what we learn every day.